Hi students, in the previous video we have discussed about the classification of business. Business we have discussed and classified as industry and commerce. Industry and commerce. What are the different types of industries we discussed there? We discussed industries into primary, secondary and tertiary. And we discussed again what are the different types of primary industries, what are the different types of secondary industries and then which are the different types of tertiary industries. Now the second part of business, that is commerce, is going to discuss. What is commerce? Commerce involves all the activities which are taken for removing the hindrances in making the exchange of goods. Exchange of goods means buying and selling. In order to make smooth exchange of goods and services, what are the obstacles are there? The removal of all such obstacles are called commerce. That means the activities taken for removal of all the hindrances in making exchange possible. That is called commerce. Okay. So we can define commerce in a simple way here. Commerce is the sum total of all the processes which are necessary for the removal of hindrances in making exchange possible. So commerce is the sum total of all the processes which are necessary for the removal of hindrances in making exchange possible. It is the sum total of all the processes which are necessary for removing the hindrance of hindrance for making exchange of goods and services possible. See, exchange, we know that, but it is exchange of goods and services. That means buying and selling of goods and services or movement of goods and services from the producer to the ultimate consumer. So that is called exchange. So we have to remove all the hindrances to make smooth exchange of goods and services. What are the hindrances in exchange? For example, some goods, suppose you have a television, Samsung television is there with you. Samsung is a Korean company and it may be producing, the company may produce Samsung television in any part of the country or sometimes even outside the country. Suppose it is producing any one part of India. So that television has to reach to your home. Okay, because it is not producing near to your home, it has to bring that product from any one part of the country to all the different parts of the country so that it should be made available to the users. So what is the problem there? Distance or the place is the hindrance. Hindrance means obstacle. Okay, something which curves or which reduces the movement. Okay, so the hindrance of place is the problem there. That means hindrance here is the place. So how we can avoid that hindrance of place? By transportation. So transportation is one of the element of commerce. Okay, and then suppose you don't know that which are the different varieties of television available in the country, in the market. Okay, you have to purchase a television and you don't know that which is the best television or which are the different brands available in the country. Okay, so what you have to do, what you will do? You have to get the awareness for that, what is, how it is possible for that advertisement is there. So there was the hindrance of knowledge. You did not know which are the available branch in the market. So that hindrance can be avoided by spreading knowledge through advertisement. So advertisement is one of the number goals. Okay, and the business, if they want to produce the products, they need money. They need money to produce the product. So that money will be provided by banks or any other financial institution. So that is also an element of commerce. So these are the various elements of commerce which helps to avoid the hindrances in making the exchange possible. Okay. So commerce is the sum total of all the processes which are necessary for the removal of hindrances in making exchange possible. Now we are going to see that which are the different classifications of commerce. Commerce we can broadly classify into two categories. Trade and aids to trade. Trade and aids to trade. These are the two different classification, main classification of commerce. Then what is trade? Trading, you know, what is trade? Buying and selling of goods and services can be called as trade. Buying of the goods or selling of goods can be called as trade. Buying and selling of goods or services can be called as trade. Okay. This trade we can classify again into two different categories. There are two different types of trade is there. That is internal trade and external trade. Internal trade and external trade. Internal trade is otherwise called as inland trade. Inland trade or domestic trade. Inland trade or domestic trade. Okay. Then what is this internal trade or inland trade or domestic trade? Inland trade or domestic trade is the trade happens within the geographical boundary of a country. The trade which takes place within the geographical boundary of a country is called inland trade. That means if we consider India, the trade happens within India can be called as internal trade of India. Okay? Understood? So in internal trade, buyers and sellers will be the citizen of the same country. Buyers and sellers will be the citizen of same country. The person who are selling the goods as well as the person who are buying the goods are the citizens of the same country. Okay, the goods will not move out of the country. Goods will not move out of the country. It will be produced and sold within the country only. Such a type of trade is called internal trade. This internal trade we can classify again into two categories. Wholesale trade and retail trade. Wholesale trade and retail. So internal trade we can classify into two categories, wholesale trade and retail trade. What is wholesale trade? Wholesale trade is a trade where the goods or services are purchased by the wholesaler from the manufacturer. In wholesale trade, goods are purchased in large quantities from the manufacturer and sells that into smaller quantities to the retailer. Such a type of trade is called wholesale trade. Okay, wholesale trade is the trade where goods are purchased in
larger quantities from the manufacturer directly and sends that into the retailer. That means the wholesaler buy the goods directly from the manufacturer and sell that to retailer. Buying that in larger quantities and selling that in smaller quantities, comparatively smaller quantities.
Then what happens to retail trade? Retail trade is the trade where retailer purchases the goods. He purchases his goods in big quantities, larger quantities from whom? Wholesaler, and sells that to ultimate consumer. Okay. So retailer purchases the goods in larger quantities from wholesaler and sells that to retailer. That means, suppose this is manufacturer. From manufacturer, who purchase goods? Wholesaler purchase goods. And from him, who purchase? Retailer purchases. And he sells that to customers. Okay. So these are the two items we have told: wholesale trade and retail trade. In wholesale trade, wholesaler purchase goods from manufacturer. That will be in big quantities. That means sometimes all the goods produced by the manufacturer will be purchased. Okay, that will be in larger quantities, and he will give this to retailer. He may have many retailers. Here maybe may have one retailer. So this is one. This is another one. Here maybe one more retailer. So many retailers will be there. He purchases in larger quantities and sells that to comparatively lower quantities to many retailers, and all these retailers will give these products to their products to customers. So retailers, how they will purchase? They also will purchase comparatively higher quantity or bigger quantity and sells to customers. How we can say that bigger quantities? Suppose let us consider the case of books. Suppose this retailer purchases books of 1000 books from wholesaler. 1000 books he purchases, and from him a customer comes and buy 2 books. Okay, 2 books are purchased by consumers. So we can say that retailer purchases in larger quantity and sold in smaller quantities. Same way, wholesaler may be purchasing 1 lakh books from manufacturer, and out of that 10,000 books are given to him. Again 5,000 books may give to him, and again 10,000 books may give to retailer like that. Okay, so wholesaler buys the books in larger quantities and sells that to retailer in smaller quantities. And as far as retailer is concerned, he purchases the goods in larger quantities and sells that to customers in smaller quantities. So that is the two different types of internal trade. Okay, we can classify as wholesale trade and retail trade. Understood? Then let us come back to internal trade. Internal trade we can classify into 3 different categories. Import, export and import. Okay, import trade, export trade and import trade. See, import trade. Before that, let us see that what is external trade. Internal trade, we have told that this is the trade that happens within the geographic boundary of the country. That means the buyers and sellers are the same citizen of the same country. Okay, then what is external trade? External trade is the trade between two different countries. At least two different countries will be. That means buyers may be in one country and sellers may be in another different country. Okay. So here the trade happens between
beyond the boundary of a country.
So external trade
is otherwise called foreign trade. We can say it as foreign trade. Okay. So foreign trade is the trade between two different countries.
So such a type of trades are of three types. First one is import trade.
What is import trade? Import trade is the trade where citizen of the country purchase goods from another country.
Suppose let us consider from
the point of view of India.
So for Indians, import trade means
the buyer will be in India and he purchase the goods from any foreign countries. Okay, he purchase the goods from a foreign country. Such a type of trade is called import trade. Buyer will be in India and seller will be from any other foreign country. Okay.
Then what is export trade?
Export trade is the trade happens between the same way between the people of two different countries. That means suppose if we consider from the point of view of India, we can say that we sell, the person, the seller will be in India and buyer will be in any other foreign country. Okay. In import trade, buyer will be in India and he buy the goods from any foreign countries. So goods comes here, goods comes to our country.
And in export trade,
buyer will be in any other foreign country and seller will be in India. That means our goods we are selling to any foreign country.
That is called export trade.
Then what it is? Entry port trade. That means this is the trade which happens between three different countries. That means we buy the goods from any country and gets that here to sell that to any other country. That means goods are purchased from any of the foreign country to sell that to any other foreign country.
That is called the entry port trade.
Okay. Goods are purchased from any of the foreign country with a view to sell that to another foreign country.
For example,
we purchase goods from England. So from England goods came to India. That we are selling to America. That we sold it to America. Okay,
sometimes there may be some trade restrictions between England and USA. In that case, a trader, so USA, the
purchaser from the
USA will make an agreement with the trader in India.
And here their agreement, they will tell that USA may say that, the trader in USA may say that you purchase goods from England for me.
Or otherwise, without their knowledge also,
we may purchase the goods from England
and from England the goods will come to India, then from there it will go to America.
So like any three countries
can engage in entry port trade.
Okay.
So here the goods comes for a short rest here.
Okay, here the goods are not used.
In this case, in this country the goods are not consumed.
It will be coming here and stored there for certain time and for up to the time of exporting to foreign.
Okay, so these are the different foreign trade, import trade, export trade, and entry port.
Okay,
so first half of commerce we have discussed so far. Trade. Trade is buying and selling of goods and services. Then that trade can be classified into two categories, internal trade and external trade.
Internal trade is otherwise called inland trade or domestic trade.
And this inland trade we can classify into two different categories, wholesale trade and retail trade. And the external trade we can classify into three different types of trade, import trade, export trade and entry port trade.
Okay.
Now let us see the next part, what it is, aids to trade. What do you mean by aids to trade? Aids to trade is otherwise called auxiliaries to trade. Auxiliaries to trade. What do you mean by auxiliaries to trade or aids to trade? Auxiliaries to trade or aids to trade are the services which helps the activity of trade. What are the various services which help for the trading activities can be called as auxiliaries to trade. These auxiliaries to trade helps to overcome the hindrances we have. Okay, various types of hindrances are there. In order to solve that hindrances, or in order to protect commerce from such a hindrances, we do such a service. Okay, such a services are called aids to trade. So aids to trade are the trade or activities which helps to or which provide services to trade. Okay, aids to trade are otherwise called auxiliaries to trade. Now let us see what are the different types of aids to trade. First, in aids to trade, you can say that transportation. Transportation is one of the aids to trade. Transportation. What is the use of transportation here? For shifting the goods from one place to another. So transportation is the process of shifting the goods or passenger from one place to another. Here, in the case of trade, we use transportation for shifting goods from one place to another. So as a definition of transportation, we can say that it is the process of shifting goods or passengers from one place to another. So how or why transportation is used, or which type of hindrances can be overcome with the help of transportation? Shifting from one place to another, passengers or goods are shifted from one place to another. So which hindrance it overcomes? Yes, it helps to avoid hindrance of place. Hindrance of place. That's what we have called. Goods may be producing in one place, and that has to reach in all the nook and corner of the country or world. So that helps through transportation. Transportation overcomes or helps to overcome the hindrance of place. Okay. Next, let us see warehousing. What is warehousing? Warehousing is the process of storing the goods. Okay, it is the activity of storing the goods or protecting the goods until final consumption. See, goods at the time of manufacture or immediately after the manufacture of the goods, it will not be consumed. Goods will not be consumed soon after the manufacturing of that goods. So, after the production, these goods are to be stored until there is demand for that. Okay, understood? Until there is demand or until there is consumption, the goods are to be stored after the manufacturing. For that purpose, we use a technique which is called warehousing. Okay, sometimes, for example, seasonal products are there. Seasonal products are there that will be consumed in that particular time only. For example, umbrella, you may be knowing umbrella. Umbrella will be consumed when there is rain. It's a seasonal product. Okay, so monsoon time or when the season where there is rain, the umbrella will be used. But these umbrellas are not produced at the time when there is rain. Throughout the year, the production will take place, and these umbrellas will be stored until there is rain. Okay, so throughout the year, the production takes place, and these products are to be kept until there is demand. For that purpose, we use warehousing. Okay,
So where does it, which hindrance will avoid or which hindrance will be avoided with the help of warehousing?
See, here in warehousing we keep the goods from the time of production to the time of consumption.
Okay, there will be time difference between the production and the consumption. So goods are kept there from the time of production to the time of consumption.
So the time hindrance of time will be overcome with the help of warehousing.
Hindrance of time, that means time of production and the time of consumption.
Then let us see the next one. Insurance.
Insurance.
So how the insurance help? Or what is insurance?
Insurance is the activity of undertaking loss for an insured amount, for an amount, or it is the activity of compensating loss for a conservation.
Suppose if you pay some money to the insurance company, they will compensate your loss when it happens.
Okay, if you pay some money to the insurance company, they will compensate your loss at the time when you get the loss.
If something happens to the insured things, they will compensate. For example, fire insurance is there. So in that fire insurance, you can register your factory or building or whatever it is to the insurance company, and they will give some compensation if it happens fire. For that you have to pay some premium.
So that is what is called the insurance. So this insurance, why it is needed for business?
To cover the loss of accidents.
Okay, that loss means some risk, chance of loss, isn't it? Chance of loss, or we can say it as risk.
That means here there are some risk in business.
That means at the time of production, some goods may be lost, or at the time of storing, some goods may be lost.
Some goods may be lost during the accidents, if there is some accidents during transportation.
During transportation of goods, if happens some accidents, the goods may be lost.
Okay, so all these loss can cover by insurance.
So insurance helps us to avoid the hindrance of risk.
Hindrance of risk.
Okay, that is what insurance does.
Then next one,
banking and finance.
Banking and finance. What banking and finance does?
What is the purpose of banking or finance?
See, for the business, in order to manufacture the goods, in the case of buying raw material or employing laborers for production, all these activities, they need money.
This money can be borrowed from banks or financial institutions.
So that also, banks and other financial institutions also help business.
Okay, so that is also an aid to trade.
So which hindrance will be overcome with the banking and financial institutions?
Hindrance of money, or we can say that hindrance of finance.
So hindrance of finance can overcome with the help of banks and other financial institutions.
And we will say one more thing, the last one. We can say that advertising.
What is advertising?
Advertising and telecommunication, everything we can include together.
So what it does? It informs the public about the products and the features.
features and use of the product. Advertising informs the public or customers about the nature, features and purpose of the products produced, the availability of the products and the nature and the purpose. Okay, that's what advertising does. So advertising is needed for marketing the products, because advertising provides knowledge about the product. Lack of knowledge is the problem with the customers to buy good products. In order to get the good product, he should be aware, he should have the knowledge about that product. That will be possible with the help of advertising. Okay, so advertising avoids hindrance of knowledge. Advertising avoids hindrance of knowledge. Okay, so these are the contents for the today's class. Okay, once again we can see trade, classification of trade we have explained. Here aids to trade, there are 5 different aids or helps to the trade. They are transportation, warehousing, insurance, banking, finance and advertising. See, transportation helps to avoid hindrance of price, and warehousing helps to avoid hindrance of time, insurance helps to avoid hindrance of risk, and banking helps to avoid hindrance of finance, and advertising helps to avoid hindrance of knowledge. Okay, is it clear to all?